So good morning everyone. Today I am going to discuss redox reactions. Okay, and in this portion I have discussed the main thing is how to balance a redox reactions by ion electron method. And okay, so first redox reaction I have already discussed in the previous video lectures. So these are the reactions in which both oxidation and reduction takes place simultaneously. So these are the reactions in which both oxidation and reduction takes place simultaneously. So that is called oxidation and reduction takes place simultaneously. So what is the oxidation reduction? I have told you. So in simple, oxidation means loss of electron, and reduction means gain of electron. Okay. So if you consider the definitions or concept of oxidation and reductions in class 10 level, so then we now come to the difference oxidation and reductions. So addition of oxygen, you know, oxidation means addition of oxygen. Reduction means removal of oxygen. Magnesium plus oxygen, MgO. CO plus C, you know, copper and CO. Removal of hydrogen, oxidation means removal of hydrogens. H2S plus Cl2, twice HCl plus S. Addition of hydrogen, S plus H2, H2S. Oxidation, increase in positive charge, Ab2 plus, loses electrons. Again, oxidation number increases, plus 2 to plus 3. Decrease in positive charge, that is decrease in oxidation number, plus 3. Again, accept 1 electron, it becomes Ab2 plus. So, increase in oxidation number, plus 2 to plus 4, SnCl2 plus 2, SnCl4 plus 4. Decrease in oxidation number, manganate MnO4 minus, here plus 7 to plus 2, decrease in oxidation number. And finally, removal of electron or loss of electron, Sn2 plus, loses 2 electron, it becomes Sn4 plus, and Fe3 plus loses 1 electron, it becomes Fe3 plus. So that is the main difference between oxidation and reductions. So what is oxidation and reductions? So oxidation means addition of oxygen, whereas reduction means removal of oxygens. As for example, twice Mg plus O2, MgO, magnesium oxide, cupric oxide plus C, carbon, you get copper and CO. Similarly, oxidation means removal of hydrogens, H2S plus Cl2, twice HCl plus S, and addition of hydrogen, S plus H2, so H2S. Increase in positive charge, Fe2 plus to Fe3 plus plus electron. Here decrease in positive charge, Fe3 plus plus electron to Fe2 plus. Now increase in oxidation number, plus 2 to plus 4, SnCl2, here stannous plus 2, here stannous T or stannous plus 4. In case of decrease in oxidation number, in case of reductions, that means MnO4 minus plus 7 and Mn2 plus plus 2. So removal of electron, that is the main difference, main definitions of oxidations, loss of electron or removal of electrons, that is increase of oxidation number. A reduction means accept of electrons or addition of electrons or loss of oxidation number or lower decrease in oxidation number. So Fe3 plus, oxidation number 3 plus, here after accepting this electron, it oxidation number Fe plus 2. Okay, now come to redox reaction. As I told you, redox reaction nothing but it is the sum of the oxidation and reduction reaction takes place simultaneously. I have discussed in the previous video lectures. So MnO4 minus plus 7 5 Ab2 plus plus NH plus Mn2 plus 5 Ab3 plus plus 4 water. So a plus 7 to plus 2 are reductions and plus 5 2 to plus 3 the oxidations. I have also discussed oxidizing reducing agent in the previous video lectures. So now, and how to calculate or find out the oxidation state of a particular element, and during from this oxidation state value we can tell the which one is oxidizing agent and which one is reducing agent. So now come to very important topic, very much important, balancing of a redox reactions by ion electron method. So there are two methods by which we can balance the redox reactions: oxidation number methods, which is not included in your syllabus, and ion electron method, which is included in your syllabus. Okay, so first first, how to find out? First, find out the reaction given is whether the ionic form or molecular form. You know, this reaction is ionic form. Molecular form means there will be no ions. So this is the molecular form reaction, this is the molecular form reactions. Okay, but this is the ionic form reactions. This is also molecular form reactions. There is no ions. So first convert molecular reaction into ionic form. If ionic form given, then divide the complete equations into two half reactions. If the reaction is given in the molecular form, then you convert it into ionic form. KMnO4, it's ionic form MnO4 minus. Here. So first convert molecular reactions into ionic form. If ionic form given, then divide the complete reactions, okay, into two half cell reactions. Two half cell means oxidation half cell reactions and reduction half cell reactions. One presenting oxidations, other presenting reductions. Okay. So redox reaction is the combination of two half cell reactions, oxidation half cell reactions and reduction half cell reactions. First of all, balance the atoms other than hydrogen and oxygen. So balance the atoms, number of atoms, both left hand side and right hand side. So both left hand side and right hand side, balance the atoms other than hydrogen and oxygen. So first balance the atoms both left side, right hand side other than hydrogen and oxygen. In a reaction taking place in acidic or neutral medium, oxygen atom are balanced by adding molecules of water. So if a reaction taking place in a acidic or neutral medium, oxygen atom are balanced, how? By adding molecules of water to the side deficient in oxygen atom. So where the oxygen atom is deficient, that side you should add water molecules. While hydrogen atom are balanced by adding H plus ions to the site deficient in hydrogen atoms. So again I repeat the point number 3. In a reaction taking place in acidic or neutral medium, oxygen atom are balanced by adding molecules of water. To the site deficient in oxygen atom, where the oxygen atom is deficient. While hydrogen atom are balanced by adding H plus ions, where the hydrogen atom is deficient. That is the side where the hydrogen atom deficient. Okay. Next, move on. Okay. In a reaction taking place in alkaline medium, okay, OH minus, alkaline medium, every excess of oxygen atom on one side is balanced by adding one water molecule to the same side and two H minus ions to the other sides. So in the previous slide I have discussed in acid medium or neutral medium. So in neutral medium, acid medium, you are adding water molecules where the oxygen is deficient, and hydrogen atom where the hydrogen is deficient. But in case of alkaline medium, what will happen? Every excess of oxygen atom, these are the very rules are very important. We should remember, otherwise you cannot or you are unable to balance the redox reaction by ion electron method. So every excess of oxygen atom on one side is balanced. If oxygen atom gets enriched or excess, then you should balance by adding one water molecules to the same side and twice OH minus to the other sides. In case of a hydrogen is still unbalanced, it is balanced by adding one OH minus for every excess of hydrogen atom on the same side and one water on the other side. So equalize the charge on the both sides by adding a suitable number of electrons. To the site difficult in negative charge. Multiply the two half cell reactions. Two half cell means oxidation half cell, reduction half cell reactions by suitable integers so that the oxidation number of electron gained in one half cell reaction is equal to the number of electron lost in the other half cell reactions. So again I tell you, multiply the two half cell reactions. When the elements and hydrogen oxygen are balanced in both left hand side and right hand side, then you should balance the electrical neutrality. So multiply the two half cell reaction by suitable integer so that the total number of electrons gained in one half cell reactions is equal to the number of electrons lost in the other half cell reaction. Add two balanced half cell reactions and cancel any term common. Any term common means generally number of electrons. So number of electrons is cancelled out from both sides. Then you get overall redox reaction. Same thing, same rule. Again I discuss in easiest way. Step 1, write the skeleton equation and indicate the oxidation number of all elements which appear in the above their skeleton equation above their respective symbols. So what actually first you convert the molecular form into ionic form, then you find out which is oxidized, which is reduced. That means find out the oxidation reductions. Okay? Then you identify oxidation reductions. Okay? Then from this you separate or split these two reactions to half cell reactions. Oxidation half cell reactions, reduction half cell reactions. So first you write down oxidation half cell reactions, then you balance the element other than hydrogen oxygens. Both sides, left hand side and right hand side. So write the skeleton equations and indicate the oxidation number of all elements which appear in the above their skeleton equations above their respective symbols. Step 2, find out the species which are oxidized and which are reduced. That means oxidation reductions. So find out the species oxidized reduced means, once you are able to find out oxidation reductions, then you can say which one is oxidized, which one is reduced. Okay? So first molecular form convert into ionic form, then you find out the oxidation number, then you find the oxidations and reductions, then you split these reactions into two half cell reactions, oxidation half cell reactions and reduction half cell reactions. So split the skeleton equation into two half cell reactions, oxidation half cell reactions and reduction half cell reactions. Okay? Now step 4. Balance two half cell reactions equation separately by the rules described below. So balance the two half cell reactions. Separately by the rules of described below. In each half cell, first balance the atoms of the elements which have undergone a change in oxidation number. Very important thing. So that's why I have written two types of methods, most of the commons. But in this case, I include some extra points so that you can understand better way and you can solve or you can do the balance of redox reactions by ion electron method. So in each half cell reactions, first balance the atoms of the elements which have undergone a change in oxidation number. So we balance that atom which undergoes a change in oxidation number. In case of manganese, MnO4 minus to Mn2 plus, Fe2 plus to Fe2 plus. So you should balance first manganese, then oxygen, then hydrogen. Okay, in case of Fe2 plus, Fe2 plus, we balance only Fe, because there is no other ions. So only element is Fe. So B, add electrons to whatever side is necessary to make up the difference in oxidation number in each half cell reactions. Okay, so add electrons to whatever side is necessary to make up the difference in oxidation number in each half reaction. See, balance oxygen atom by adding required number of water molecules. So balance oxygen atom by adding required number of water molecules to the side deficient in oxygen atoms. In the acidic medium, hydrogen atoms are balanced by adding H plus ions to the side deficient to H plus atoms. However, in basic medium, I have already discussed, hydrogen atoms are balanced by adding H2 molecules equal to the number of, to the deficiency of hydrogen atoms and equal to the number of OH minus ions including on the opposite side of the equation. So remove the duplication if any. So that is the rules. By following these rules, we can balance the redox reactions by ion electron method. Okay. Step 5, two half cell reactions are then multiplied by a suitable integers so that the total number of electron gain in one half cell reaction is equal to the number of electron lost in the other half cell reactions I have discussed. So two half cell reactions are then multiplied after balancing all the atoms, multiplied by the suitable integers so that the total number of electron gain in one half cell reaction is equal to the number of electron lost in other half cell reactions. So the two half cell reactions are then added up. Okay, these rules are illustrated by the following examples. Step 6, verifications. To verify whether the equation thus obtained is balanced or not, the total charge on the either side of the equation must be equal. So that is the rules to balance a redox reactions by ion electron method. So balance the redox reaction by half reaction method. So Br2H2O2 BrO3 minus plus water in acidic medium. So what have the question is given in the ionic form. Okay, Br2 BrO3 minus, no need to change its ionic form. Okay, and also it is mentioned the acidic medium. We should apply or employ the rule of acidic medium, not basic medium. So you should balance the redox reactions in acid medium. So, okay. So now, as per the rule, we first write down these reactions and putting the oxidation number of the elements. Here Br2, you know, is the allotropic or neutral molecules. So homonuclear molecules, 0, H2O2, minus 1, plus 1. So BrO3 minus, here X plus 3 minus 2 equals to minus 1. So X equals to plus 5. So that's why, so bromine is 0, 2, plus 5. Oxidation number increases. So this is the oxidation. Similarly, H2O2 oxygen is minus 1 here, okay, and here oxygen is minus 2, okay. So that is the reduction. So what I told you first, after identify the oxidation and reductions, we should split that reactions into two half cell reactions. So split into two half reactions, oxidation half cell reactions and reduction half cell reactions. Okay, so Br2 first oxidation half cell reactions, Br2 to BrO3 minus. Okay, you see in oxidation half cell reactions, Br2 to BrO3 minus. Okay, how? The first bromine is balanced, so number of bromine atom balanced in both sides, Br2 and 2Br. Now come to the oxygen molecules. So oxygen molecule means, here you see the oxygen is in the right hand side, 3 into 2, that is 6. So first balance the element which is undergoing the oxidation number changes, Br2O, that's why bromine is balanced. Then other than hydrogen oxygen, then come to oxygen. So in the right hand side oxygen is 6, in the left hand side which is deficient side oxygen 0. So how to balance the number of oxygen atom? By adding water molecules where the oxygen is deficient. So that's why I put 6 water molecules in the left hand side. So what will happen? Resulting the number of oxygen atom is balanced. So Br2 balance, oxygen 6, oxygen 6 balanced. Now another problem arises. What problem? Again, so balancing oxygen. So this is the balancing oxygen. Other problem means, now come to hydrogen. So in the left hand side, hydrogen is 6 into 2, that is 12. So balancing hydrogen. So hydrogen, how will you balance the hydrogen atoms? So balancing hydrogen means hydrogen balancing by adding H plus ions in the right hand sides. So 12 H plus ions balancing. Why H plus ions? Because it is mentioned in the acidic medium. So that's why I put H plus ions. Now look at this. Twice bromine, 6 oxygen, 6 oxygen, 12 hydrogen left hand side, 12 hydrogen right hand side. Okay. So number of atoms, all the atoms are balanced. Okay. All the atoms are balanced. Now H2O2 water, reduction of cell reactions. Okay, H2 come, but oxygen is not balanced. So that's why we should apply twice water molecule right hand sides. Okay, now balancing here. I forget to tell you, here the charge balance, electron balance, how many positive charge? Here 0 charge, here charge 12 charge, okay, and 2 negative charge. So as a result 10 negative positive charge. So 10 positive charge excess. So in order to maintain the electrical neutrality, you should write 10 electron in the right hand side, 10 negative, 10 positive, because already here 2 negative, 10 negative, 12 negative, 12 positive, that's why it is balanced. Okay, similarly here 2 electrons gives 2 negative charge, 2H plus. Why? You should add not here electron, you should add here, that will be the better, because here after balancing oxygen, hydrogen atom should be balanced. So hydrogen here already 2, so you should write 2H plus in the left hand side. As a result 2 positive charge. In order to balance the 2 positive charge, we should multiply or we should add 2 electrons. So these electrons in the left hand side and these electrons in the right hand sides. Okay, now come here balancing total charge. So here 2 electron charge, here 10 electron charge. So how will you balance the electron charge, electrical neutrality? So if you multiply this equation into height, then you get 10 electrons. So 10 electron cancel out. So equation 3, Br2 plus 6 water, 2H BrO3 minus plus 12H plus plus 10 electron into 1. Or you can do not write into 1 because it is already 10 electron present. Now you have to, what you should do? You have to do the multiply 5 with this H2O2 plus 2H plus, so that you get 5H2O2 plus 10H plus plus 10 electrons. Okay, so that 10 electron cancel out. This is the big, okay, left hand side, this is the right hand side. So 5 into 2, that is 10 water molecules. So Br2 5H2O2 10H plus 10 electrons, 6 water twice Br3 12H plus 10 electron, 12 10 water. So 10 electron cancel out. Finally we balance this reaction Br2 plus 5H2O2, that is twice BrO3 minus plus 4 water plus 2H plus. So that is the complete balance reactions. I hope you understood. Okay, this is the very very important. Another examples, MnO4 minus Br minus, MnO2 plus Br2 minus in acidic medium. So balance the equation by ion and electron method. Again I tell you, this is the given in the ionic form, not a molecular form. So your job is less. So just you find, just you identify the oxidation reductions, plus 7 plus 2. Okay, so what will happen? Here Br minus to Br2, minus 1 to 0. So oxidations, so oxidation reduction you identify, then Br2 to Br2, so 2Br, bromine is not balanced in the hydrogen shell to HBr, so here 2, so 2 negative charge, in order to balance there we put 2 negative charge, so this reaction is balanced. Okay, now in case of Mn4- to Mn2+, manganese-manganese balance, but oxygen is how? 4, so that's why I put 4 water molecule hydrogen side. Whenever as soon as put 4 water molecules, hydrogen atom is 8, so that's why I put 8 H+ ions in the left hand side, because it is acidic medium. So now number of electron is 5, here number of electron 2, so it's, this reaction should be multiplied by 2 and this reaction should be multiplied by 5, so overall reaction will get this, so 10 electron cancel out, so finally we get Mn twice Mn4- plus 10Br- plus 16H+, so twice Mn2+ plus 5Br2 plus 8 water molecules. So this is the method to balance the ion redox reactions by ion electron method. Next, move on. Another, balance the redox reactions by ion electron method. Again, zinc Zn plus NO3- Zn2+ plus NH4+ in basic medium. Okay. What will happen? Again, I tell you the same thing. We choose or find out or identify oxidation reductions. So, zinc 0 to plus 2 oxidations. Okay. So, in nitrogen plus 5 to minus 3. So, this is the reduction. So, once you find out the oxidation reduction, then your job to split this reactions into two half cell, oxidation half cell, reduction half cell, as the reaction is given in the ionic form. So, there is no need to change the convert molecular form into ionic form, because the reaction already given in the ionic form. So Zn2+ zinc balanced, oxidation half cell. So only we put here 2 electrons, so number of charge is balanced. But in case of NO3- to NH4+, what will happen? Nitrogen balanced. Okay. But now oxygen is not balanced. So how this balance? Again, NO3-, so you should put what good 3 water molecules in the right hand side. What will happen? 3 oxygen balanced, but hydrogen is not balanced, because hydrogen is 4 and 6, 10. So balancing hydrogens. So balancing hydrogens, 10 water molecules, NH4+, 3 water and 10 OH-. Okay. So 10 plus 20, 20 hydrogens, 4, 6, 10 plus 10. As it is told the basic medium. So the finally we get zinc to Zn2+ plus 2 electron, NO3- 7 water plus 8 electrons. Okay. So NH4+ plus 10 OH-. 10 minus 3, that is 7 water molecules. So now here electron is 8, here electron is 2. So in order to balance the electrical neutrality, it should be multiplied by 4. So Zn 4, 4 Zn, okay, it should not be, because 8 cancel out. So 4 Zn plus NO3- plus 7 water, 4 Zn2+ plus NH4+ plus 10 OH-. So again I tell you, so balancing the redox reaction by ion electric method in both medium, acidic and basic medium. So first in basic medium, so zinc nothing problem, only put 2 electrons, solved. Okay, now come to NO3- NH4+, nitrogen balanced, oxygen balanced, we put 3 water molecules, but as soon as we put 3 water molecules, we should put how? Because here 3 plus 2 6 plus 4 10 water molecules, 10 hydrogen atom, so that's why I put 10 water molecules. Okay, how, what will happen? 20 H+ ions, 20 hydrogen atoms. So in order to balance the extra 10, we put 10 OH- ions. Now 10 water molecules minus 3 water molecules, you get 7 water molecules. So NH4+ 10 OH-. Now balance the electron, number of electron, here 2 electron, here 8 electrons. So you should multiply this equation into 4, so that the electron gets balanced, 8, 8. So 8 cancel out. Okay. Now finally you get 4 Zn plus NO3- plus 7 water. So 4 Zn2+ plus NH4+ plus 10 OH-. And disproportion reactions are redox reaction in which a same element present in a particular compound in definite oxidation state is oxidized as well as reduce simultaneously is this proportionation reaction. H2O2 plus 1 and minus 1 minus 2 0. So minus 1 minus 2 0. Okay. So this is the oxidation state. Particular compound definite oxidation state is oxidized. That means dispropion reactions are the special type of redox reactions. One of the reactants in the dispropion reactions always contains an element that can exist at least three oxidation state: oxygen minus 1, 0, minus 2. Three oxidation state. The element in the form of reaching substance is in the intermediate oxidation state, both higher and lower oxidation state. As I told you, both oxidizing and reducing agent of that elements are formed in the reaction. Okay. So redox titration or oxidation reduction titration. In a redox titration, a reducing agent is titrated against oxidizing agent and vice versa. So in a redox titration, a reducing agent is titrated against oxidizing agent and vice versa. Redox titration includes those reactions in which one reactant is oxidized and other is reduced. So in redox titrations, a reducing agent is titrated against oxidizing agent and vice versa. Redox titration includes those reactions in which one reactant is oxidized and other is reduced. So that is, redox titration involves the change in oxidation number or transfer of electrons among the reactant substance. So according to international convention, redox reaction is written as OX plus N electrons reversible sign reductions. The reduction potential of the system is given by the non-stipulations. So E0, E equals to E0, electric potential, standard electric potentials. If you write minus, then reduction will be in numerator. So plus 0.059 by N. N means here, N means number of electron lost or gained. Log molar concentration of oxidized and molar concentration of reduced form. Oxidized form and reduced form. Where E0, standard reduction potential, N, total number of electron lost or gained. Now standard electron potential, the electromagnetic force which measures the tendency of a molecule, atom or ion. The electromagnetic force which measures the tendency of a molecule, atom or ion towards electron loss or gain under standard condition, that is at 1 atm and 25 degree centigrade, is called standard oxidation or standard reduction potential, which is denoted E0. The algebraic sum of standard oxidation and reduction potential of a redox reaction is called redox potential. So algebraic sum of the standard oxidation and reduction potential of a redox reaction is called redox potential. Standard redox potential, standard potential values are very helpful for predicting redox reactions that would occur simultaneously. For spontaneous reactions, the redox potential should be positive. For example, standard reduction potential of the two systems are MnO4- 8H+, 5 electrons, you get Mn2+, 4 water, E0 value 1.51 volt. Now Fe3+, accepting 1 electron becomes Fe2+, E0 value minus 0.77 volt. What will happen? Actually, MnO4- plus 8H+, plus 5 electron, Mn2+, 4 water, E0 value 1.51 volt. Similarly, 5 Fe2+, 5 Fe3+, 5 electrons. Okay, so what will happen? E0 minus 0.77 volt. So, electron cancel out. So, overall reactions, MnO4- 8H+, 5 Fe2+, Mn2+, 5 Fe3+, 4 water, E0, 0.74 volt, which has been shown here. So MnO4- 5 Fe2+, plus 8H+, MnM2+, 5 Fe3+, 4 water molecules. So that is the point I told you. Actually, this is the redox reactions. So in redox titrations, the commonly used oxidizing agent are KMnO4, K2CR2SO7, potassium chlorate, KIO3, etc. And commonly used reducing agent as more salt, ammonium sulfate, ferrous sulfate, six water, ferrous salt, stannous salt, oxalic acids, sodium thiosulfate. So in redox titrations, a commonly used oxidizing agent, KMnO4, K2CR2SO7, KMnO4, you know, redox more salt. How much Fe2+ present in the more salt? By permanganometry, KMnO4. potassium dichromate, KClO3, KIO3, and commonly reducing agent, more salt, ferrous salt, stannous salt, oxalic acid, and sodium thiosulfate. So these are the salts which are used in the redox titrations. So in the next video lecture, we will discuss the redox, type of redox indicators, redox titrations, and the electrolysis. Okay, so I hope you are enjoying this video lectures. Thanks for watching this video.